Hola mi gente, my name is Estrella, and like a star, I'm gonna shine some light on y'all. Welcome back to my channel, and to our final interview episode. Last week, I got the chance to sit with Luna and talk about her experience with employment in Los Estados Unidos. It made me realize that school is only the first gift that mi mamá gave me by moving here. I will also have a chance at getting a better job after college because of my status and education. I won't take that for granted. I will miss Luna so much, but I'm so happy that I will always have these videos to look back on. Today, I'm interviewing mi mamá. It's getting so real now. I'm almost fully packed, and my little brother even started moving stuff into the closet of my room. Well, his room, I guess. I've already said goodbye to my friends from high school, and some of them already moved into their dorm. I can't even picture how I will feel when that's me. But in about a week, that will be me. Today's featured suggestion on things to do when I arrive in New York is call mi mamá. Of course, it'll be the first thing that I do. Even all the way from East Los, she would find a way to ground me si no le hablo. The question I chose from your suggestions today is, do you have advice for other immigrant parents? Let's hear some of what she has to say.
Lista. Buenas tardes a todos. Pues, primeramente, I want to say that I am very much a believer in God. Y que soy una mujer bonita, alegre y muy fuerte. Oh, y me llamo Ofelia. Mucho gusto. My English no es perfecto, but it's enough to get me through communicating the simple things. You know, like the easy hello and how are you and goodbye, or como lo dices tú, bye. Ay, mira, hija. I did not learn English in a classroom. I learned it from the people around me. It took many years of just listening to it on repeat. Pero yo prefiero hablar en español porque es la idioma de mi tierra y puedo comunicar mejor porque me siento más cómoda. ¿Entiendes? I feel more confident speaking Spanish, just like you feel more confident speaking English. No debemos dejar que se pierda nuestro idioma. ¿Sabes qué? ¿Tus YouTube amigos quieren mi consejo? Ahí les va uno. A los padres que están mirando en este canal, cuando ponen sus hijos en clases a donde hablan puro inglés, van a aprender solo inglés. Y eso no es bueno. Porque es muy triste que a pasar el tiempo no nos entendemos como padres ni hijos, porque cada uno está hablando su propio idioma. Ese es el error que yo cometí como madre. ¿Verdad? Entonces, por favor, padres y hijos, aprendan los dos idiomas, porque if we learn both languages, nos movemos adelante. Y si no, pues ya se me olvidó qué iba a decir. Ay, muévame a otra pregunta, por favor. For a long time, I felt isolated here. I didn't have much of a say when it came to coming here because I married tu apa, David, at 16, and he brought me here. And well, as his wife, I belong to him, not the other way around. The idea of belonging to someone has always caused a conflict in me. Pero así son las cosas. That's the way it was back then. El hombre David was in Mexico was not the man he was in the United States. Maybe due to the simple fact that a change in location changes you. It's subtle, pero ahí está. He would come home from work on a bad day y no lo conocí. Porque ya no me dio el mismo cariño que antes me daba. He stopped giving me kisses goodbye or hello. He stopped calling me cariño o reina o amor de mi vida. That job was sucking the life out of my David. Pero gracias a Dios, empezó a ir conmigo a la iglesia. We sought out help because we were going through a rough patch in our marriage. And I refused to raise my kids with parents who did not respect each other. You and your brothers probably don't remember because you were still too young at the time. It took many years, but I think we fixed our marriage. I love David with all my heart. I just didn't expect the transition to be so difficult. But we made it work for our family. I think we did a great job. I mean, all of our kids are either going to college or have a good job. And most importantly, they are all good people who lead with their hearts. That's all a mother can hope for, right? With that and some grandchildren. Apúrale, estrella. Ya quiero ser. Ya quiero un bebé. No me digas que ya fue todo. Ay, pues qué rápido pasa el tiempo, ¿verdad? New York, huh? Out of all the schools, you choose the farthest one. Ay, hija. What an honor it has been to see you grow into the strong y valiente mujer that you are. Thank you.